And we are live. Hello, everybody. Once again, we are probably not going to be spending too much time on actual Capecraft this morning. However, I do have 2 hours this time. So maybe we will. It depends on how far we get with this. So let's turn light levels off. So yesterday we built this and we ran into a couple of issues. We need to get F3 and G. We need to get this to follow a chunk or be as close to this as possible. So there are a couple of things I'm thinking we can change about this, and I'm just going to remove this for now. I was thinking yesterday while I was at work as far as how we could go about changing this. And I'm thinking we need to think about moving up and then pulling. I did not want to break that beacon, and then end up pulling from the edges. And we can use the same idea of what's it called? The same idea of the observers to pull up and down from these edges here. Let's try that out. So we have these. And they need to come all the way down this way. And what we can do, these are always going to be on or off, and they're going to turn on or off. With the chunks loaded. So we can do this. Come back. Now we've got everything up by one. Now, normally this would not work between chunk borders, and that's something we have to keep in mind. This has to be in one chunk. If this beacon goes over a chunk, then we have to think of a different idea. This way, this way, this way, this way, this way. Which I know some beacons will go over chunks. Okay, let's see, we need to go up by one more. And up by another, and then we can come this way. Nope, back. And these. Okay. So that kind of works, but the issue is that it can come out of sync. Like it currently is. Currently, these are in the incorrect states. Let's put them in the right state, and we'll go home, which is back down this way, and we will change the state and see that it reflects it on the other side before we move much further. So I'm going to turn on the middle one and off the edge. We should see these reflect each change. And those reflect it. Awesome. That shouldn't be a thing. No, I guess it should. Hold on. No, that's right. Okay. Yeah, I was thinking maybe I managed to push these through, but no, that would actually max it out. Okay. Fair enough. Right? Yeah, that was definitely it. Okay, because these would have pushed out those, not those. Okay, so yeah, these can go out of sync, and we'll have to keep an eye out for that. But that keeps all of this in one chunk, and if we can keep our beacons chunk aligned, then it works. Hello, Eliza. Okay. So from here, what we can do is basically what we were doing before, which is pulling a redstone line from these guys. But we're going to do it up to the edge of the beacon. So here to here, here. and block them off. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Oh yeah, that's gonna work. Let's see. Yeah, we're not gonna be able to do it that way. Hoping we could stick a door in the middle. And then this will be the output on the other side of the beacon. So it's currently these three out. And we could technically bring this up by one more. Or down by one more. Let's bring it down. That works. But then there's that issue. Okay. Yeah, we're wanting this to be as close to the edges of the beacons as we can. Bring it back. Take these three out. Is it? No, hold on. So this one goes down to here, then this one goes down to here. Okay. There we go. No. Oh my gosh. It is gonna be a bit of a per beacon situation. Okay, not what I wanted. And then it's these three out at the moment. Okay. Let's go see how that reflects. We'll be all the way back down here, and I'm going to bring them all in this time. So all of the beacons should be on. So one, two, three. We'll see how that looks. In, and in. Awesome. So that works. I'm thinking these shouldn't be beacons, though. Or, observers, I mean. We should leave these all the way up to the edge to be, what's it called? I love how that's completely obliterated any sense of comparison there. Okay, we should leave those to be continuous streams. And this will be as best as we can get this. Now here's another thing. Can we alter the beginnings and ends of this design to match that? So we've got this set up here. And our beginning is repeaters. So let's do that. So these and this. So here, here. Nope, hold on. Forward by one. Okay. So essentially what I'm wondering is if I can alter this to still include this guy. Okay, this has got to go up by one. That's one thing. So I'll have to alter the end here. That'll be as simple as doing this. No, it's not, because now we have to deal with these. So we'll have to go forward by one on these. Okay. And that, and that, and that. And then we'll have this. So if I activate this redstone line, only that one fires. Activate. Need to figure out a way to activate that redstone line. I'll have to turn these off. Only that one fires. And then one, only that one fires. Perfect. That looks like it works for me. Now we need to get that over there. So it'll be a similar setup. Come on, place in the right spot, please. And back to there. One, no, one, two, and then this will be forward by one. Then we'll have our redstone blocks here. Okay. And redstone dust down here. Come on. Perfect. And iron block, please. Oh, that's an issue. Hold on. This redstone dust connects. What can we use there? A trap door? No, because that's going to have two states. Just use a dispenser. And a repeater. That'll work. So the issue I'm running into here is that redstone was connecting there. So we would have problems when this line turned on, it would turn on all of them. A trapdoor would have two states, so it would turn on, then off, so we wouldn't spit out our blocks up here. Then the same thing would happen if I were to use a fence gate or something along those lines. I don't know why this side isn't triggering. That's kind of terrifying. I guess we'll find out. Okay. Time to go test. We're going to turn on. Let's make sure all of that's synced up. Yep, this just looks weird because it's sticking up by one. Those beginnings and ends are going to be fun to do on repeat. However, this is going to make it a lot easier to make sure all of the beacons are lined up. So we're going to do the edges and the center. Each one's lining up okay. And this one's not. Oh. That is so strange. A power change is not updating or sticking out the block. Huh. Okay, what if I do this? What is doing that? Okay. Let's check this out. So I've got two of these. Oh yeah, that's totally gonna work. Do it this way. That's working, so what's going on here? Oh, is that butted? No? You are very strange. Okay, let's see. How can we mitigate this? We've got the pistons at a height that we can manage them here. Can we bring this redstone down at all? Say like this. There is a redstone dot, but that's not gonna help. Okay. Hello, Ewan! I don't know what's going on here. How does that work? No, that doesn't help because now we can't power these. See, and that's not even necessarily a good height because now we have to bring it down two steps. Huh. Like we have the signal here, we just need to get it down there to be able to go on another one of these tracks. Whatever reason, my old design wasn't working. We bring these out. Oh, no, don't do that. Here and up. Let's try it this layer. Okay, so that's definitely butted. Down by two, how it was, is shouldn't be butted. But it is, somehow. Something about this is making that not stick out its block. And that's kind of important here. Why not just steps down? Because then I can't separate the redstone lines. If I have steps, then it ends up being like this. And it won't actually step. So that's a bit of an issue. With this kind of stacked close by redstone, you can't use steps down, and that's kind of frustrating. And I can't think of any other way to do vertical redstone that close together without honey blocks, which isn't coming until 115. Honey blocks would really make this a lot easier. Because I could do basically just this. But then it's going to come out of the range of this, Ewan. Like, I needed to fit within the beacon boundary. So, this whole project may have to wait until 115 because this would make this just entirely possible. If If I could just move my redstone up and down the beacons using that, then this would be a lot easier. Because I could just go down and out on the edge of the beacon using these rather than having to go down and forward. Down and up and over, nice and easy, rather than having to use observers that I don't trust. And that would make everything here way easier. I mean, items can be vertical redstone, but it's not the best. Why does the redstone have to be in the boundary? Because I'm trying to fit everything within a chunk boundary, and having to fit something else on the edge of the beacon is a problem. It has to stick within at least the chunk boundary. I've got this side pretty well sorted out. And there's like a pretty close margin of error on the edges of the blocks that I'm having problems with. Let's see. If I have an example, where did I post this? Did I post it here? No, it doesn't look like it. Okay, hold on. Dum-da-dum. Grab this, please. I think this is it. The Photoshop file, so it's going to take a minute. So I mapped out everywhere where I'm placing beacons, and I don't have much wiggle room. So I do need to wiggle them a little bit to where they're in the same chunk boundary, though. But that means I have to adjust the other beacon to where it's also within a chunk boundary. I did not think of the fact that the beacons themselves had to be within a chunk. The reason for that is I don't want half the beacon being activated and the other half not, because it's not going to receive that signal. Come on. Okay, yes, I'm definitely missing a beacon here. That explains that. I've got this area marked out, and I'm definitely missing a beacon there. Okay. I hadn't pulled this up yet. I am missing two beacons. So, need to fix that. So, I don't have much wiggle room here. On these, I do. I have quite a bit. This one, I don't, and these three, I don't. But I need to wiggle them into chunks, and they're not all chunk aligned. This one, I have almost no wiggle room because there's so much stuff around it. Like, I can't move it one block up because there's a smelter array. I can't move it one block down because there's a wall. I can't move it one block this way because there's a farm, and I can't move it one block this way because there's another wall. There's no wiggle room there. So we may end up having to do something else with this, if not just move it here. I mean, I could conceivably move it out here. That's the best I can do on that front. I really cannot move it anywhere where it currently is. I don't know how chunk aligned it is, though. But that's why I'm trying to fit everything into one chunk here. I could sacrifice this here, or not one chunk, the beacon. Because I'm not going to have much wiggle room. I could come out one more, but that's not going to help me too much. And again, I don't get what you're saying by going out by two, Ewan, because that still blocks this off. I can't allow this to go down while simultaneously al not allowing this side to go down. That doesn't work. Could you swap them back and forth somehow? Hold on. So if I go two this way, allow a gap. I'm gonna experiment here. So let's go here. Two, down by two. Two, down by two. Okay. And then we'll start here, go out by 3. Down by 2. Down by 2. Okay, I guess that works. Guess I stumbled into the answer on my own. Okay, let's figure out how far we'd have to go over on that front then. Let's see. So we need, yeah, that's gonna be pretty far. Need to go out by 3. Down. Yeah. That's the problem. I can't. Oh, well, I guess I could. Because it's the solid redstone blocks. So that's not an issue. Because I'm not having... Okay. Yeah, it's a solid placement. It's... Okay, fair enough. Be honest, this is going to be an absolute pain to build in survival. Well, you can pass into the next chunk higher up. I could, but it's pretty difficult. Like, yeah, this is the example. So when you have to move up or forward at all, you end up having to stagger these. Which is annoying. Because you can't just move them forward into blocks. You have to stagger them or you're going to power multiple pistons at once. So you see these are activated, but then these aren't. So you have to stagger them forward each time you go up. I figured that out. But yeah, like we could just bring these all the way down to whatever level we need to be at. That's definitely a possibility. I don't see that being an issue at all, considering we're pulling directly from solid redstone blocks. Okay, so we need to put the redstone dust in here. And redstone dust on this. I'm trying to figure out where exactly we need redstone dust. It's not everywhere. Or not redstone dust, solid blocks. Well, you're only still doing 2 layers. Right. Okay, so now it's down. Down. Nope, this comes out. No, you couldn't. That happens. Quasi connectivity for the win. Yeah. That's fun. That is the most fun thing. Okay, what do you mean then? Yes. However, have you seen the area I'm going to build this in? I don't want to have to dig 5 blocks up. So I guess I could move the beacons 5 blocks down. Hmm. I do have to move most of the beacons anyway, because I built them at the wrong layer. So this is supposed to be at Y40. I built it at Y50 because I didn't bother checking before stream the other day. This is Y40. Yeah. Yeah, that's actually probably a better idea than having to go up and then down. Let's remove this test. I'm gonna stack. Wand, please. I don't want to ruin what I've done so far, so I'm gonna stack this all the way out to here. And here. Okay, hello? Let's check this out. This is probably going to be much easier. Thank you for mentioning it, Ewan. Because like I said, this part, while cool, and I never thought of it, it's going to be an absolute pain to build in survival. Okay, let's see exactly what level we'll have to put it at then. We're going to delete these, and then I'm going to move the beacon down until it's level with the redstone blocks coming out of these. And then we would just need an altered one of these to go over. And then not only that, we wouldn't have to worry about the specific placement of the beacon. We just need to pull pistons coming off of this. Because they're already at the right height. Okay, so it's... Oh, geez. Why is this so far back? Okay. And repeaters, please. You could step in chunk and then after go up slash down. The step in chunk before and after to go up slash down. I'm not sure what you mean. Let's try 3. Okay, looks like 5 was the right idea. Okay. Yeah, this is supposed to be back by one more. Can I place in the right spot for once in my Minecraft life? Here, 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 and here. No, that's still the wrong spot. I designed this. I should know how to build it. There we go. And it'll be these. Okay. And this is on and off. Perfect. So then to get the signal over there, it would just be the same deal. So... And all we would need is a break midway. Like so. I need this, 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 and this. Oh, I've got that completely backwards here. Okay, and redstone repeaters all the way across. Perfect, and block, block, piston, block, piston, block, and repeater, repeater, just across. And dust. Come on, can I place that there? Thank you. Now we don't have to deal with any sort of fuzziness. Like, everything's always a redstone block. And a repeater. And a redstone line. That's perfect. And it makes everything look a lot cleaner, not having to move up and down all the time, too. Okay, that works for me. It just means we have to have a break midway that just converts. And it's basically just a repetition of the same mechanism. So we can go from here to here. Just do 10. Oh, thank you. I didn't want to have that. Should have removed the scaffolding block beforehand. And then here we can set this up. Do an abnormal combination this time, rather than a mirrored one. And there we go. That works perfectly. Awesome. We got the same output on this side, so it'll go on to go to another one. And now what we need to do is we need to have a junction, because if we look at our map, we've got this coming out the middle, but then somewhere along this line, we'll have to come down here. We'll have to get this one. We'll have to split to get these two. We'll have to split to get this one. So we need a T and we need a turn. Because, well, we can just turn this. I think that's going to make the most sense. That one should go that way. And then those will be fine. That one will be fine. That one will be fine. This one I'm going to have to turn. Well, I could just come down from up here. Could I? No. I'm going to have to come across here. I also have to think about how these are going to be loaded. So you need to make out a way to go 90 degree. Right, so I need to make a 90 degree turn and I need to make a split. So imagine going like this and going like this. Those are the two shapes I need to make next. Should not be the hardest thing. So let's do a T here. Looking at this, it may very well be, and I'm just stupid. We'll find out. He says, yeah, I know. Like I said, we'll find out. Okay. So we've got probably more than this space to work with. Going to need more room, probably. Well, I need it to fit in a chunk, is the thing. I still absolutely require that. I have more space to work vertically. Okay, let's see. About the space I have, let's figure out how we're going to go about this. Keep the lines separate. Yeah. We can't do vertical redstone blocks. It's nice having a set already of lines to separate. Some cases that's annoying. In this case, it's quite useful. Okay, let's try this. Okay. I feel like I'm missing a line. I am. I'm missing the top. Missing this line. Okay. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Perfect. Okay. Well, let's leave it on that mode for now. We have to keep in mind this is the inverted signal. And then can pull from this side. And we've got everything flattened too. Oh gosh, now we have to unflatten it. That may not be the best option. Unflattening is hard. Okay, let's try this. Actually, that. Okay, so we've got the true signal going out this way. So that'll be our junction. Then it'll be this one and this one. And then this one. Oh, that's an issue. No, that works. And then one. One, two, three, four, five. Bring this out by one more. Okay, that matches. So then now we need to get this signal to attach back to here. And what we have is an inverted signal on these torches. So we've got one torch here, one torch here, one torch here. So there's four. Where's number five? That this one? That is that one. Okay, so let's put a repeater here, a torch. And then we'll get our inverted signal for this set. Okay. Start bringing it this way. So that'll be this first one. Yep, this one's supposed to be live. Looks good. And then we want to get this one. Let's see. Nope, we've got that one done. So it'll be this wire next, which will be that guy. Yeah, that's not gonna work. I do that. There we go. Oh, that's not gonna work. We'll need two repeaters. Oh, this is an absolute mess, but it's working. Let's see. Now we need you to go to that one. Don't need those two blocks. And that's the proper signal. So we're going to go down, across. That should be nice and easy there. Okay. We need to get you across. So we'll do a repeater. No, that's not going to work because we'll power this line. Let's get this. Is that the current line? That is. That's inverted. Try it this way. We need to get this line to there. We'll drop it down like this. Maybe we shouldn't have inverted that. Leave it like this then. And then we'll invert it here. Looks good to me. And then this one next. That one's already inverted. We just need to get that down here. So it'll be down and over. Okay. Think we did it. So we've got two and up. Two and up. Aha! We have done it. Now we just need to make sure we have the same output. So here, and it changes. Because I'm afraid I have managed to swap the direction of the output. So we've got two on the right and one up on the left. Two on the right and one up on the left. Now we need to make sure it actually swaps. So let's go back to the beginning and we'll follow it through the train and make sure everything looks good. Let's do everything on the left and one in the center. Okay, so one did not change. Oh gosh, now I have to debug this. Did it update correctly on this side? It did. And this is correct. So let's see. One of these lines is incorrect. We've got everything. What is messed up? Everything here. So it's everything on the right should be active. This line is wrong. That's traced back to here. Should that? That's inverted. It shouldn't be. Where is that getting its signal from? Oh, okay. I see the issue. So we need to do that, and we need to put a repeater right here. There we go. We did it. Hey, Ewan, I have successfully made a junction. It's a mess, but I made one. Ah, geez, that's an absolute mess. Okay, now the next question is, can I even make it look better? Or easier to build in survival without pulling my hair out? Because this is crazy. Let's stack this and we'll try it out. It'll be here. No, that's back too far. It'll be here. Here. Okay. Why did that one not update? Okay, we may have yet another issue. Oh no, I think this is just. Nope, that's an issue. We're getting power on this line somewhere. Where though? Where do we have power level 15? Right here. Oh, okay. Repeater. Right there. That'll fix it. Perfect. Let's go fix that on this model. There we go. Couldn't notice because that block was already active. Okay. So let's do a single test of each one then. So that's on. That's on. That's on. That one's on. Wait, this is swapped. And that one's not on. Hold on. The left one's on. Right one's on. None is on. Okay, so I have not successfully made a junction. Got this here. Yeah, I have managed to swap the direction of this. Where's why this one's not turning on? The line's live. Did I double this one to here? Here. Oh. What? Where is this getting power from? Here, of course. Really need to keep an eye out for that. Okay, so now that one's on. That one. At center, no matter what. So that one's working. That one's working. Left. Right. Yeah, I have swapped them. Okay. That one's fine. Left, right, left. Okay. So let's fix the errors I made in this one. So I need a repeater there, repeater there, repeater there. Got a repeater on that one. Don't need one there. Okay, I think that's sorted. I have no idea what you're saying, Ewan. Those first three words make no sense to me. As long as we cross the chunk using the piston system, we could take up more than one chunk. In theory, the issue comes that we still need to load the chunks as we cross the island, and there's no guarantee that each junction will be loaded. Okay, so looking at the map, the central hub is going to be here, right? Let's say I go from here to this corner. I would want the junction to be as close to this hub as possible to get to that corner. So let's say here, right? Then it would split off and go down this way, then this way, then this way. As long as we use blocks and pistons as possible. Right, but now I have to keep that even closer to the center, and it's going to be an absolute mess because now we have to have all of these junctions close. That's what I'm saying. Like, I'm not going to have a lot of space close to that. Because I have to keep all of the junctions within a very small area. Because I want them to stay loaded in the case of, oh, I've turned everything off and I don't want anything to happen. But as I'm moving around the island, I need everything to update. The most of the junctions are going to happen not in, well, at that point, is it better to just have a hub rather than a bunch of junctions? And just send out as many wires as you need? Wouldn't that be easier than having a junction? Yeah, I get that a junction's possible, but going on that idea, is a junction even the right thing to do if there's no guarantee that it's going to happen? So my issue is the best place for a junction would be here. Right? So wouldn't it be better to just have one a hub underneath here that has the junction right there, sends out a line that goes like with this and that way, with this and that way, with this and up. So send, oh geez, I just deleted that. To send out three separate lines rather than one. You can't guarantee that it'll be loaded when I go down this way and up, though. That's the issue. And that's something else we have to think of, is how is this one going to be loaded when I go this way? See, I know you can guarantee, you can't really guarantee it being loaded. That's the issue, Ewan. Right, I know. You can guarantee the other half of it being loaded just fine, but not the whole thing being loaded. Yeah, it'll work if it's loaded. So I'm saying this half of it's loaded, and it goes and sends the other half of the signal, and it works. My issue isn't with whether or not it'll work between two chunks. I know it's possible. My issue is with whether or not the junctions are even a good idea when it comes down to can we even get the signal to where we need to when moving around the island? Okay. Let's see. So I managed to get the first one done, but I then swapped the inputs. So this one's inputting on the left, but it outputs on the right. And I'm still trying to figure out how I managed to do that. Okay, now I see. That side's the right, and I've mapped it to the, or that side's the left, and I've mapped it to the right. That kind of makes sense. It looks right from this perspective because I've basically just done this. But I needed to do quite a bit more than I did. I kind of did it the really simple and stupid way. It works, but only if you don't care which side your input comes from, or if you have something that'll swap it on the other side. Okay, so we need to swap the inputs. I wonder if it would be better. Pull from this side. Let's see. Come on. Yeah, that's not going to make any difference. I'm still going to be rotating at the same angle. Can I please have that block? Okay. So, let's bring this back down to this level. Like I said, I'm not 100% sure the junctions are even the way to do it when it comes down to the problem of making sure that each beacon gets activated on its way. But I'm not sure how to go about verifying that because there are multiple ways I could get to this beacon. So I could either go diagonally, which doesn't guarantee either path, or I could go down the paths. I'm really not wanting to build these diagonally, to be honest. That's just not going to be fun. I mean, diagonal would probably be the best option. I guess the main thing would be maybe we change it to where it can accept multiple inputs. But I wouldn't even know where to begin with doing something like that. But this island isn't necessarily big, but trying to do something like this on such a scale is a bit of an issue. Because we need to make sure each section gets loaded properly. I maybe, but my thing is that if I'm here and I turn off this beacon and I go down here and over, how do I know that this beacon's off? Because it's not going to be. Because I'm going to be going down this way and over to get to that beacon. Single line or junction is no different. Right, that's what I'm saying. I'm trying to figure out how to go about solving that problem because I don't think either is going to make a difference unless I have multiple lines going to the beacon from different directions. I did kind of just state that. I don't think it makes a big difference how I get to it unless I can take multiple redstone paths to get there. And then it just gets super complicated because it's getting conflicting instructions. And it has to figure out which one to respect. Right, it just doesn't work. Unless you're starting to go beyond what basic redstone can do. And at that point, I might as well just be chunk loading. There we go. Yeah, I get that. I get that the junction doesn't make a difference, but thinking about how that would work brought this issue to mind. Because I've got to think about the placement of the junction. and how that would relate to the beacon. Now, the easy solution to, oh, I've walked up to this beacon and it has the wrong effects, would be to just walk back down wherever the redstone path is, and it would just activate it. It wouldn't break. It would just be the incorrect effects. And I don't think that's the worst solution. And I honestly think that's the only solution. Because we're trying to design this to be foolproof. It wouldn't necessarily work all the time, but it wouldn't be something we'd have to go down and fix. And I think that's kind of the key thing. We just have to walk back down the redstone line. Okay, Ewan, let's go over two chunks then. Wand. I did not want to throw my wand. Thank you. Move 16. /set hand. Thank you. Okay, we have two chunks of space. Now let's see. We'll need Now that's interesting. So we'll need to cross this chunk boundary with that. The issue then becomes, we're having to cross it again. Are we crossing split already? Move this 3 blocks. So we're going to cross in 2. Well, let's grab these again. We'll have to remember that this is split, so we need to this is mirrored, so we'll need to redirect it. Okay, we're gonna grab this. One, two, three, four, five. Torches. Okay, and iron blocks. Okay, so this one is currently mirrored, but it's turned. Now, we need to duplicate it. So we've got this coming back out this way. So we can split the lines before they get to the junction chunk. Got it. Okay. Not wanting to move that up by one more. I want to keep it where it is. Or join the next chunk or both. Right. It kind of depends on how it ends up working out. Let's see. We've got the bottom line sorted out here. will be the top line, I guess. Okay, so there's that one, and then here's this one. So it'll be here and here. We're gonna do a dust, two repeaters, block, dust here. So there's that line sorted out. That kind of works, I guess. Again, I am still super surprised at how complicated this is. Okay, now we need to get the lines from these torches out. Ooh, that one's a bit of a mess here. I don't think I can actually get that one out. Or can I? That one's inverted. Then I think the next one's here. Yes, but we'll need... Okay, so this one will need to go forward. Okay, and where is our next one? So we've got line one and line two from the ground. We should have line three from the ground. So one, two. Where's line three? Is this line three? This is line three. Okay. So now we're going to go on this level. It's ground level one. Let's try this a little bit differently. So we've got proper level here, so we're going to go here. So that's that one. And then this one can literally just be this. Hold on, that's ground? Yes? Maybe? Getting so lost. Yes, that is ground two. And then this one here is ground one. We're gonna go here for that one. Ground one goes here. Ground two goes here. Where's ground three? It is here. We need to invert this again, so we're going to do this. Okay. And now we have top one. You're annoying. If I do this, who yells? Nobody! Awesome! Okay, so you are currently inverted here, and then re-inverted here to get the proper output. And then I need to invert it again here. Now, let's leave it as is. Pull from this line. Okay, there's ground. No, that's top two. We'll invert there. Okay. The one. No, it's. I put this in the wrong spot. This goes here. Means this needs moved back somehow. That'll work. Maybe. And I can't put it there. That block powered ever? Yeah, we can actually remove that one. Nope, can't remove that one. Okay, that'll work. That one can go, that one can go. Hello, Novice Galaxy, welcome to the stream. Up two goes here. Can't do that. We're gonna do the same invert system we did last time. We'll have to come down to here. And instead of having a repeater there, we'll have an inverted torch. And then we'll go from here.
You make me happy,
Thank you for the follow,
Fowl.
Novice Galaxy.
So
Happy to have you.
very happy.
Okay, so that's a bit of an issue. Can't go up against this side because we've got that redstone, but we could do this. Okay, and now we're going to take that here. And we need to go all the way to there. So we're going to come out by one this way. Need to invert. And I think I have the proper output here, Ewan. Look. What do you mean, look hard? Very confused. Okay, there's that. Now I need pistons and a redstone block so we can actually test this. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pistons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Thank you. And we're going to come back here. We're going to do full test. So we've got one on the right. No, it's still flipped. We've got one on the left on these. How? One on the right. How did that come out to be one on the left? Ah, I'm trying to get a logic system set up for converting or for sending signals through multiple beacons. And it's not working because I keep somehow managing to rotate the signal on this junction. Ah, dang it. Wait a second. One on the right. Oh, wait a minute. That's just because I'm a moron. It's not rotating. Right. And I look from here, it's on the left. Okay. I'm just a moron. Ignore me. So, right, if you're looking from the correct orientation. It's correct. We got it. Ewan, are you still there? This is my second attempt. This was the first one. And looking at it, we ran into the same issue, and this actually works. So, Ewan, we have two working designs here. What issues do you have? I'm gonna go get a popular response. If I have in one chunk with no inversion, there's no inversion. That's the thing. Like, the inversion was a trick in my head. Look, if you look from the correct orientation, you've got right side, right side, right side. It was a trick in my head because you input backwards. It inverts on its own if you look from the other side. Look, so you input on the right side. But then when you're looking from the other side, it flops. Because you yourself have turned around. This is the kind of thing that breaks my head. Yeah, I literally just turned around and said, no, that's the wrong side. There's no inversion. It's literally just I'm stupid. I don't know which design I like better, though. Like, I could easily rotate this and stick it out that way. This one's kind of more compact, though. A lot more of a mess, that's for sure. Yeah, I don't know. The first? Yeah, it is a lot more compact, but it's definitely a mess. I think the compactness kind of helps. It'll take less resources. And then this can rotate out this way just fine. Yeah, I think Ewan's kind of upset now. I tricked him into thinking I was stupid. Well, I think I was stupid either way, so... Yeah. Guess that's what we're going to end up using. Now, we need to get a right-hand turn. So we need to come from here. Let's just stick... No, that's not going to work. We're going to have to stick the pistons a little bit further back. No, I'm not using torches at all. See Discord. Okay. And you got it all to fit in one chunk, too. Okay, for those wondering, this is what he sent. And that is way better. Ewan actually knows how to do this in real life. He is an actual, like, electronics person. I'm horrible at this, if you can't tell. So my assumption was I needed to move vertically a lot more. So yeah, that may actually be what we go with. Mine is just bridging lines. Yes, mine does work. Ewan's apparently does work. So, yeah, like, both are definitely options. I think Ewan's is probably better, though, looking at it. Because it's just redstone dust and repeaters. So, we're probably going to end up going with that one. I want to see what I can make on turns, though. Because there are going to be a couple of instances where we have to turn. I want to bring those out by one more. Correct. Correct. So this one to this one to this one. Get on the right page, please. That would be helpful. Mine can be modified for a turn. Oh, that is true. Because you can just remove the second piece. Okay. Why is this broken? You're still outputting three. You should only be out... Oh, that's right. I didn't update this one. Let's just break it here. Sure thing, Ewan. Yeah, we might just end up going with that one. Because if I need to do a turn, it would just be removing the ones that continue. Fair enough. So I guess since we've got all of the logic on that front sorted out, let's go look at beacon placements. And we're going to do this in spectator mode, just so it's a little bit faster. Okay, so this one works. Next beacon is over here. Ah, this one's going to need changed. This one's actually not all that important, though. Its main purpose is to just cover this island. So this one we can move nice and easy. Where's the next one? This guy. That one's going to need changed. That one can be moved nice and easy. Let's check out the one that we're going to have a lot of problems with. Yeah, this one's going to need moved. Well, no. We could do it here. We would just need to do some very precise positioning of those lines. We would need it to end up right here. And then, yeah, that could work. Oh, no. Yeah, we could do it. We would just set up repeater lines here. That'll work. And then that one's moving. What about this one? We already checked it. This guy. That one works. And this guy. That one works amazingly so. Okay. And this one. And this is going to be our hub, by the way. That one works. Okay. So it looks like that's all set. No, I don't want hitboxes. I want to turn off chunk borders. So I did manage to get quite a few more of the beacons in place. And I've been digging out the area down here, and in preparation for getting those redstone lines in, I've been digging up two more. I see. Awesome. Okay, let's get that downloaded and uploaded into MultiMC. In preparation for getting the redstone lines in, I have been digging the ceiling up by two more blocks. So that we actually have room to work. Because I think the actual thing ends up being three blocks high. So, two block ceiling wasn't working. I'm actually going to start planning out where the lines are going to go tonight after work. Can I actually see my worlds thing? Where are you going? View worlds. Thank you. Drag. Drop. Awesome. So, yeah, that's going to be pretty fun. I love how yours was just barely opened after mine. Okay, let's check this out. So he pulls them up. That's how he goes vertical. Okay, so you literally just went up and stayed down rather than having to deal with the inversion. That actually works pretty well. Okay. Build bottom three first, it's easier. Okay. Cool. That works for me. Yeah, Ewan is an absolute expert on these, so I would have thought the entire time in order to move vertically with any sort of agility, you had to use redstone torches to have that sort of thing. But I guess having to deal with the inversion makes it a lot more space consuming. So, yeah, that makes sense to me. Well, on that note, since I kind of got everything I needed done, that's not going to be just completely agonizingly slow, since a lot of what I have left to do for this project is moving those beacons down and marking out the redstone paths. I'm going to call it for today. I will be back tomorrow. See, tomorrow is Saturday. I'm really wanting to do some Sprout, but we'll see what happens. I have to find some things to do on there. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. Have a nice night, and I'll see you then. Oh no! OBS has crashed. I really got to figure out what's going on with that. So, no end screen. It's just going to be a quick close. Have a nice night. I'll see you tomorrow.